Gentlemen, before we start, did I hear cut?
No.
There was a laugh?
Hayden? Oh, hi, everybody. Listen, I'm...
How much do you want to give to help save the sea green turtle giant, sea turtle giant?
What the hell you got in your head?
Oh. Kelly gave it to me. She got it from the theater department.
How could you screw that line up?
I would never ignore a plea for help. How dare you imply I was insensitive?
Who said you were insensitive? But dressed like that, I can't help but think you are. I'll see you later. I gotta go.
Wait, Coach, stay.
I'm gonna dunk you, Hayden.
Why?
I have no idea why.
Thanks, Cap City. You're great. I said it in the wrong order.
Jackie Mason's TV show was ailing so badly this year that not even chicken soup could bring it back to health. So ABC pulled the plug and turned to its bench for a substitute. Off the sidelines, back into the ratings game comes Coach.
You got put into the schedule, to use a football term. Right after Roseanne.
After putting chicken soup on waivers, ABC has called in Coach to fill out its Tuesday night lineup.
Too bad they couldn't get you a better lead in, huh, for tomorrow night?
Hello, is Jerry there?
Yes.
Oh, could I speak to him? This is Jackie Mason.
Yes, just a moment.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello, Jerry.
Yeah.
Hello, Jerry Van Dyke.
Yeah.
How are you? This is Jackie Mason. How have you been?
Good, Jack.
Yes, sir. Okay, listen, so I understand. I'm walking with my friend Sammy Shaw, and he tells me that you don't like my show. Now, what is this?
Just a second. Tell Craig.
So what are you going to do now if this TV series makes it?
If this series makes it, I won't know how to handle
it. It's all over for you.
I'm doing my best to screw it up, as Craig will tell you, you know.
So what's the matter? Is he afraid to talk to me?
He hates to get into conversations when he has to memorize his lines on Friday.
Oh, is that what he's doing right now?
Yeah.
Oh, I understand this. So in other words, I'm not going to get to talk to him.
You can talk to him right now.
All right. Not that I don't want to talk to you. You're a nice person.
Well, I understand.
I admire your talent. I love your work. Whatever it is you do.
Both. Talent and work.
Well, let me explain the pecking order around here, Coach Watkins. Top priority is football. Then comes men's basketball, and then men's wrestling, and then men's volleyball, and then men's table tennis, and men's kayaking, and men's choir practice, and men's rock face climbing, if that's what they want to do, and then have some time. And then, and only then, and after that comes everything that men...
Hey, listen, let me talk to Richard Widmark.
Richard Widmark? Yeah. What are you talking about, Richard Widmark?
Who is this?
This is Jackie Mason.
Seriously?
What are you? I have nothing better to do than to call a person and just waste my time and talk to two people I don't know, and it's not Jackie Mason.
No, I swear to God. I swear to God. I mean, it's, you know, I swear someone's put me on.
If it's funny, they'd still be on.
Did you hear, Craig? If Jackie Mason had been this funny, you'd still be on.
Can I tell you something? I think I'm being insulted here.
Who is this? Come on!
All right, I gotta go. Thank you very much.
I love the look on that girl's face tonight when she walked in there work with you. Here I go again.
Hey, Doc, what are you doing here? I thought you had a date.
I was. I gotta talk to you, Coach. Ah! Boy, I'm lying.
What do you do when you get a ticket, a parking ticket?
What do you mean?
When you get a parking ticket on campus, what do you do with it?
Well, what everyone else does. I give them to the homecoming queen. Well, no, actually, the homecoming committee. See, what I do is I give it to the homecoming committee.
With tax, that will be $3,180.
Well, let me help you carry that to the car.
Action.
I'm sorry.
Still rolling.
Sure sick of these crackers.
Need the administration to fight my battles. I'm taking you on, Hayden Fox. This is war.
I am shaking.
This is war.
Gentlemen, as a cook. Hi, how you doing, Stace?
Wait. Give me one second.
Here we go.
It's not from Stacy's entrance,
no,
is it?
No, no.
Okay, let me tell him real quick.
Okay, Stace, hold on till I'm done, okay? Okay. From the
hot dog, Memphis, Tennessee, the video I ordered finally came.
What video?
The search for Elvis. It's an amazing and startling documentary. You know how much I love Elvis. I can't get it out. I can't get it out.
You're looking after it.
Oh, God.
You don't know how crazy he gets when he's involved with a woman. You did not have to live through Glenda Starkweather and Naomi Peterson and Rayona Sapp.
Who are they?
Well, I think they're the three great ones. I mean, you don't know what it's like. He's going to be mooning all over the office like some sick dog. This is Farnsworth and Peterson and that other person that I never can remember the goddamn name.
I hope everybody likes Greek.
Yeah, great. That's good.
I hope everybody likes Greek.
Yeah, that's good. What do I say?
Love it. Luther is on his way up here to propose to Marion.
Oh, my God, no.
Yeah.
Look.
Is it your turn?
Uh-oh.
Single, attractive, healthy, earning a good living. Do you know how many women my age are dying to meet a man like you?
How many?
I could name six in my bridge club alone.
It's 18.
Six. Luther. I don't think you realize what a valuable commodity you are. A man your age, single, attractive.
Well, that's 18.
There he is. My guy Tucker, what a fella. How you feeling?
I think I feel okay, Coach.
Well, that's good, because you sure look like shit.
Hey, when are you going to get over this? You've been on the warpath for 2 weeks now. Slamming doors, yelling at everybody, banging your foot. Huh?
Well, I'm talking about investments. I'm talking about something serious, you know, like real estate or bonds or a solid business. You know, something conservative.
This is conservative. This is the most conservative thing they had in the whole Elvis catalog. I mean, you should have seen some of the junk they had in there. I mean, I almost bought a bag of Elvis's hair from the barbershop in Memphis, but they wouldn't guarantee it. I mean, if it was Elvis's hair, you know, it's gold. If not, it's just, you know, a $200 bag of hair.
Well, I tell you, if you got $200 invest, why not invest in something that do you some good, like shock therapy, huh? Right.
Hey, when are you going to get over this? You've been on the warpath for 2 weeks now. Yelling your head out, barking at everybody you see, slamming. This is the most conservative thing they had in the whole Elvis catalog. I mean, you should have seen some of the stuff they had in there. I mean, I almost invested in a bag of hair from a Memphis barber shop, but you know they didn't guarantee it.
Yes, of
cash from the coaching staff. Everybody chipped in, the ground was taken, it's a bonus.
I decided to stop while I was ahead.
Oh, Christine, stop while you're ahead, man. You got a slab of concrete and two white lines. That's nothing. I mean, come on, Christine. You got them cracking. You got them breaking. Now's the time to go for the big one. Go for the gold, Christine. Have a beer. I'll see you later.
Did you Christine get a job back?
Oh, yeah, sure did. And 5% raise.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
Gee, that's true. I bet she's thrilled about that.
Yeah, well, she will be when I call her. She wasn't home.
Where was she? Where in the hell are we here?
I need the line now.
Let's cut.
Well, I've got all the lines I have. I've given her.
She must be thrilled.
Yeah, well, she will be when I tell her. I've been trying to call her. She's not home. Hmm. Oh, shit. Sorry.
Man's a movie star. What's the matter with you?
What do you mean, what's the matter with me? Oh, we're doing that scene?
I don't know what we're doing. I'll start with what's the matter with you.
We're rolling.
I keep blaming somebody else, yeah.
That's right.
What's what? The door doesn't open. No, that's in the scene. It doesn't open. Then you say what's wrong, and then I say, don't you have it?
Didn't we drop something yet?
Yeah. I don't think so. Well, yeah. Sorry, I start with what's the matter with
you. I got it.
All I know is I say what's the matter with you.
Well, that's really rough. That's all you got?
I give a shit what you
say. I got a whole paragraph.
I don't care. I got mine.
Dad, now I know that you think you are never wrong. But you know what? Sometimes you are. And this time may be one of those times, Dad. Because the thing is, now I'm doing what you keep doing, right?
Camera's on you.
Okay, well, they're rolling.
I'm just saying, if you're advertising all you can eat breakfast, then legally, you have to let you eat as much as you can. What's the matter with you?
Well, there's been a stupid screw-up. Howard Brainless Burley, our athletic director. Huh? I got it. I just can't look at Jerry when I say it.
Dubba, you will take your clothes off so we can all look at you.
Isn't as easy. This ain't no poltergeist. It's tough stuff here, boy.
What is this, the history of the whole world?
Well, it's a very, it's what?
Very thorough examination.
It's a very thorough examination of the course material.
Can you do that?
Why? I don't know. We can pick it up. It's a nice picture.
Oh, see, I didn't know.
Okay, yeah. Well,
you learn something every day. Well,
whenever we're doing it, we never get to do that.
Two donuts, please, coffee. Now,
what the hell is that sound?
It's an owl in the rafters.
Oh.
Keep rolling.
No, but can those there?
Did we hear that?
No. Keep rolling.
Sorry, I heard. They're back!
Where are the little kids?
They said they're not coming out.
I don't blame them.
Thank you.
Oh, shit!
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances. Strangers in the night.
Dad?
What?
Do no wrong, and when I hold you in my arms, my love.
smile. So nice, so nice.
So good, but I got you.